Thank you. This is a phone call. Thank you. He called me a cunt. Oi, you're a cunt. I thanked him for the compliment. Couldn't conceive of anything more beautiful to say. Thank you. Handed this piece of paper by myself to myself. It says doing fine. I like to be told I'm doing fine because I'm very insecure up there. So I might as well do this poem called Doing Fine. I told you that I loved you. I told you what I was going to do to you, and I got you all to myself. I told you there was a loud cackle on the line. I think you've got the wrong number, love, but keep talking, you're doing fine. This is called, it's the title book, our poem is this little book. It's called Recital. Very classical. Talking and laughing in bed, my hand innocently between your legs. I nonchalantly tap out with nimble fingertips Tchaikovsky's 1812 Overture Opus 49. Complete with canon, which somehow tickles your fancy. I then conduct you through a series of sparkling renditions of various popular classics. Palazzian dances with its awesome chorus, Carmina Burana in all its magnificent madness, the Radetzky march with its joyful swagger, before ending up with your own personal favorite, Kachaturian's catchy saber dance. My fingertips a blur, glistening with syncopation. You in particular line the peculiar wild trombone slide and all those delicious descending little tickly notes that leave you panting in repose. All played out. This is a little poem called Akai, But No. It's about my greatest fashion mistake. Sophie has often said that I am one's great fashion mistake. I have never repeated this fashion mistake, and I will never repeat it again. It happened to be 80 degrees. I was dressed very inappropriately for what was going to happen to me next. I was just recovering from being paralyzed, and I was just thinking of leaving England and going back to Ireland, and I was 2 days away from going back to Ireland, and a certain lady turned my head, and I didn't. This is a story of what kept me in England. It's called Akai But No. It's so hard to hide an erection in a kilt. It's so bleeding obvious as to just what it is. It's here because it's here because it's here. It's so hard to hide an erection in a kilt whilst attempting to be an upstanding member of society. And then there's that embarrassing interlude waiting for it to wilt, but that's neither here nor there. It's so hard to hide an erection in a kilt, especially one this well built. I see for yourself. Here, here, order, order. It's so hard to hide an erection in a kilt. You think, is there no end to it? And one doesn't have to advertise or neon sign it, and it's impossible to doubt, deny, or disguise it. It's here because it's there, and it ain't going nowhere. It's better to come clean, face up, and be a man about it. Yes, it is hard to hide, as I've already said. Have you been listening to talk? An erection in a kilt. You try it. So I whipped it off and tossed it casually as could be over my left shoulder. Your dress fell to the floor. Oh, there was more, but I thought it best to skip the rude, crude, almost pornographic bit. Suffice it to say, we let nothing get in our way, reducing the distance between us. You and very happy Venus. I am very happy. Peace. Thank you very much.